Next, elections in the former Yugoslav Republic of Bosnia, a country torn apart in a civil war and still divided by ethnic loyalties. Special correspondent Kira Kay has our report.
Election season in Bosnia and Herzegovina is in high gear. Pumped up rallies, marches through historic neighborhoods, television debates filling the airwaves. On October 3rd, citizens will cast their votes for president on down to county representative. The extremely complex geographic and political system here means there are 8,000 candidates in this country of fewer than 4 million people. In the country's capital, Sarajevo, the activist group DOSTA, which means enough, is trying to help voters navigate the forest of candidates and get them engaged with the issues. Voter apathy is a major problem here.
So this is the vote meter tool.
DOSTA's coordinator, Darko Burkan, shows me how his vote meter works.
We've got 48 questions on different issues. This, for instance, healthcare, employment, social politics. We have all of these you can answer with, I totally agree, up to I totally disagree.
Darko's primary targets are young voters. Almost 80,000 of them are now eligible for the first time. An entire generation that has come of age in the years following this country's brutal ethnic war.
I'm 18 years old. I'm going to vote this year, and I'm going to elect because I want a new country.
At the DOSTA event, we meet Alan, born the year the war started and orphaned when his parents' car hit a landmine. Corruption and education are his issues.
I go to the high school. Our education is very expensive. We give a lot of money for books, for internet and other things. I need somebody who will help me to educate, but not to give a lot of money.
Alan also says he worries about an increase in ethnically divisive politics.
I don't care if he's Karim or Muhammad or his name, I don't care that. Or which religion he is, I don't care. He's my friend, I'm playing basketball and that. That's important.
Do you think the politicians understand that?
No, they're not understanding.
In many ways, this country is still recovering from the war that tore it apart in the early 1990s. More than 100,000 people were killed. Mass graves are still being discovered today. Buildings remain pockmarked from years of shelling. The agreement that ended the war in 1995 carved the country into two autonomous ethnic entities, a Serb-majority area called Republika Srpska, and a federation predominantly of Bosniak Muslims and Catholic Croats. DOSTA coordinator Darko Burkan says now, 15 years later, there are three distinct societies here.
The segregation that's happening in Bosnia after the war is something that everybody's getting used to. You got young people of 18 to 20 years that kind of don't have friends of another ethnicity, are deprived of all the normal things in life.
Once so diverse it was called the Jerusalem of Europe, Sarajevo today is around 80% Muslim. The city of Mostar, famously joined by a symbolic bridge, remains largely segregated on opposite banks of the river. In some regional schools, students play together during recess. But when the bell rings, the Croat students make their way to classrooms on the first floor, while their Bosniak Muslim playmates head upstairs for their lessons. They also use different textbooks for language, geography, and perhaps most troubling, history. And in the Serb entity capital, Banja Luka, the issue of national identity is potentially most explosive.
Ethnic identity.
It's very logical, even expected, that the ethnic identity of the young people here means their love for Republika Srpska is greater than their love for Bosnia.
Social psychologist Serjan Puhalo says these personal divides are being exploited by the region's politicians.
Nationalism is a tool which provokes fear in people in Bosnia, and it's a tool used for manipulation. In the war, no one won. The war goals of the three sides were not achieved, and all of them still feel somewhat endangered.
Perhaps no one is capitalizing on this more than the current Prime Minister of Republika Srpska, Milorad Dodik, who is now running for Serb entity president. At a rally in the Serb heartland town of Prnjavor, his speech featured the usual political promises of better health care, education, infrastructure. But it was also filled with the rhetoric he has become famous for.
Only in Republika Srpska are we free people. Only here are we on our own land. Republika Srpska forever, the country of Bosnia as long as we have to.
Indeed, Dodik has been signaling that Republika Srpska may not remain part of Bosnia much longer. He has threatened a vote on secession and warned Serbs they will lose their autonomy if the country is pushed to integrate in its bid to join the European Union. Integration, he says, means dominance by the more populous Muslims.
You cannot force us to love Sarajevo when it is 96% Bosniak Muslim. That cannot be our capital. Our capital is Banja Luka, then Belgrade, and not Sarajevo.
It is clear that the rhetoric is seeping down into at least some of the young people here.
It is better here than in the Federation, for sure. It's much better. Today they are trying to attack us more, and our prime minister doesn't let them, and that is good.
But in a much smaller venue than Prime Minister Dodik's rally, there are also signs of change in the political culture of Republika Srpska.
In Bosnia and Herzegovina, fear rules. In Bosnia and Herzegovina, something is coming back that smells of 1991, and therefore you've gathered here today.
Zdravko Krsmanovic is also Serb ethnicity, but he is gaining a reputation as a uniter. As mayor of the city of Foča, he has reached out to the Muslim community and welcomed back those cleansed during the genocide. And as part of a long-term strategy of change, he is drafting young people to join his party as candidates.
Good evening, good people. I'm glad you came in such big numbers, but I am even more glad to see so many of my generation. And I say to you, ciao.
Ciao.
Ivana Sandic is only 22 and still finishing university. But she's also running for a position in Republika Srpska's parliament.
These past years were very difficult, and people have started to understand that the next 4 years will be even worse if something isn't changed. The time has come for the professional and educated people to deal with politics in this country and to open it towards the European Union.
I sat down with Ivana and a few of her friends. Their Serb identity isn't as important as other issues, they tell me.
What needs to change? What's wrong with the leadership right now in Republika Srpska?
Unfortunately, young people are only considered by the politicians during election time. And during the 4 years of their term, they do nothing for them. A large number of my educated friends have had to leave the country because they simply couldn't find a job.
Onion's finishing up school and worries he won't get a job. 58% of Bosnia's young adults are unemployed. Boris says he thinks the Serbs and the Muslim-Croat Federation should draw closer together. Economics major Andrea is sober about the political battles that remain ahead.
I'm not sure that we can achieve something in a short time. If we want to make some real, deep change, we need to start from the beginning. I believe that during my lifetime, changes will happen. Whether that will be in 10 or 20 years, I still cannot say for sure.
Srđan Puhalo says time is on the young activists' side.
You can't stop the flow of information. Today we have internet, we have cable TV, and thousands of other ways. So no matter how hard you try to hide them in a cocoon, the information still gets through to the young people. And on the other hand, the war is slowly being forgotten, and we are turning more to everyday life.
But a few days before the election, Serb candidate Milorad Dodik and his Nationalist Party are ahead in the polls. The frontrunner for Bosniak Muslim president continues to call for a more centralized state, even if against Serb wishes. Unless there's an upset, it appears it will be at least another election cycle before change comes to Bosnia.